Just so I think she would say,
weather.
I want you to have one.
You don't mind, you know, you can order with the one. I still want one. Thank you.
Sure, I'm a little
can't walk around with a portable. It's got it. Probably because I might need one.
Come back to me and tell me Mark. Mark, is it running? Cut it.
present these students with more to symbolize their high academic achievement. Janessa Lois Williams.
At this time, we would like to introduce our student speakers, beginning with our valedictorian, Stephen Sherrard, and our salutatorian, Susan Ross. Our selected student speakers tonight include Janessa Williams, Rose Chang, and David Finkenbeiner. Stephen.
Dean Denison, Dr. Kelly, Dr. Charter, Mr. Knight, faculty, and friends. I'd like to part from the usual topics that are talked about at graduation and talk a little bit about nutrition. I know that everyone enjoys eating, and there's nothing better than a good smorgasbord with plenty of dishes to choose from. I would like to think of high school as a sort of huge smorgasbord. Half of the fun of a smorgasbord is going through the line and deciding what types of food you want to eat. Some people try a little of everything, but others concentrate on just a few dishes. The more choices there are, the harder it is to make your decisions. The same is true with high school. The various types of food are the many courses and activities that there are to choose from in school. Some people like to do a little bit of everything in school, while others concentrate on a few select things. The important thing to remember when you are passing through this smorgasbord called high school is to make sure you get a balanced diet that is high on nutrition. The opportunities presented to the students are like the many different dishes. They are opportunities that are either taken or left behind. And like many smorgasbords, once you've gone through the line at high school, you cannot go back. Therefore, it is very important that you take what you need the first time through, because you'll not have the chance to go back for seconds. It is said that procrastination is the thief of time. This applies to all situations, even eating. While going through this smorgasbord called high school, it is important not to procrastinate. Don't put off taking a serving of some dish, and you will have more time for it later. because by the time you come back for what you left behind, it's usually gone. Another thing to remember while you're passing through the line is to make sure that you pick out a well-balanced meal that is properly suited for your taste. Take the types of food that you enjoy and that you will be satisfied with after your meal is over. Be careful in your selection of foods also. In addition to nutritious foods, there are opportunities for you to obtain substances that could be harmful. Why eat a good, well-balanced meal and then ruin the flavor of it with smoking, alcohol, or drugs? When I passed through the food line at U-High, I made sure that I took generous helpings of the main dishes. I took plenty of the meat and potatoes, that is, plenty of English, math, and science, and received the nourishment from them necessary to take me through life. But meat and potatoes alone does not make for a very well-balanced meal. I also found time to dabble in a few side dishes at U-High. These included activities like band, swimming, and golf. I also put in a special side order for a generous helping of the 4-H program outside of school. All of these things combined formed a well-balanced diet consisting of several foods from each food group. There are many people who have a great influence on the types of food that I selected while passing through the line at high school. The biggest influence on my selections came from my parents. They were always there to help me make the proper selections. Sometimes my parents put stuff on my plate that I didn't think I would like, and sometimes they had to struggle to get me to try certain foods. But many times, after I tasted something that I thought would be terrible, I discovered that it was delicious. Without parents putting things on our plates for us, many of us would never have discovered what turned out to be our favorite type of food. Teachers and coaches also play an important role in our meal. Along with our parents, they can help us pick out the proper types of food for our particular system. The coaches and teachers are like the seasoning that we put on our food. They help add to the flavor of the food that we have selected. Now that my meal is over, I'm not quite as full as I would like to be. I got plenty of meat and potatoes, but I wish that I would have taken some additional side dishes or more of the side dishes that I did take. As I was going through the line, it looked like I had more than enough to fill me up. But just like everything else, once it is gone, you wish you could have had more. My advice to anyone who has not yet passed through this smorgasbord is to be sure to concentrate on the staples, but don't neglect the side dishes. The staples provide the nourishment and help strengthen the mind, but it's the side dishes that balance out the meal and make it enjoyable. The side dishes contain elements that are just as important to life as the staples. Too much meat and potatoes can make us big and ugly, but with the proper diet, we become lean and beautiful. But this meal is now over, and it's time for my classmates and I to venture forth to bigger and better eating places. Many of us will go to college or technical schools, while others will go into the armed forces or pursue other places to dine. All these places have an excellent selection of food, and I'm sure that everyone here will have no problem in choosing a well-balanced meal. Just as the taste of a good meal lingers inside of you for a while after you've eaten, I hope that the memories of the good times that we have all had here at U-High will stay with us for a long, long time. Thank you.
If nature has given you the power of success, you must use it or forfeit it. power on you shall be dissipated. Just as a man might possess great physical strength, yet do nothing worthy of it, so a man may have in him great mental sources of wealth, yet be very poor because he does not develop them. He may be richly endowed with the most eminent success, yet be a failure. Above all, nature endows the power of success to one who wills. There are tens of thousands of people to whom nature has given sufficient intelligence and opportunity for success, but who never succeed because they neglect or refuse to exert sufficient effort to surpass the crowd. Success belongs to one who dares win it. The determination to win success, position, and honor lies within your grasp, and any accomplishment can be had by anyone who is willing to pay the price. The only real limitations to success are those which you set up in your own mind or accept as insurmountable. You have to raise yourself above obstacles instead of letting obstacles raise themselves above you. With this in mind, we can now move on to new, even greater accomplishments. Thank you.
This one evening makes all the past ones that were filled with exasperating horror worthwhile. I'm overjoyed that those closest to me could come to share the special occasion. So many people had confidence in me when I felt that I was a failure. My little brother and sister boosted my spirits with their undying support. They eagerly attended many school functions in which I participated. They watched me accept many awards, and they even watched me do my homework at times. But more importantly than that, they cared. Each afternoon after school, we took the opportunity to share our experiences, good or bad, of our day. I don't know how I would have made it through all this time without them. Throughout my life, my most fervent supporter has been my mother. I don't know how I would have made it without her either. She never questioned my ability to excel. She spent much time explaining to me why things are the way they are. She helped me with my assignments, often spending much time typing papers that I waited till the last minute to do. The things I appreciate most from my mother are her love, devotion, and her caring attitude. She believes that a mother is not one to lean on, but one to make leaning unnecessary. This has been a valuable asset to me in my high school life. The knowledge that I could try anything, and if I should fail, she could be right here to help me. I've learned a lot from my father also. Although we disagree on many things, we have learned through time to love and respect each other through our disagreements. With this help, I have learned to deal with other people in a good way also. That's my family, and this is my way of saying thanks and I love you. To my fellow graduates, I would like to say, we have all suffered through the homework, experienced the agony of doing poorly on an important test, but we've also had a good time together. We've gone to dances and parties, football games, basketball games, and other things. We have participated in a variety of extracurricular activities, ranging from the chess club to the clarinet, drama, speech, debate, the fall and spring sports. However, we are fortunate to have attended U-High, where much emphasis is placed on the atmosphere as the actual learning. We didn't have passes to move about in our own school. We didn't have teachers hovering over us at all times, waiting for us to commit an error so they could sentence us for obese detention. Rather, we had teachers who cared about each one of us as individual students. We even had the chance, many of us, to learn each teacher as individuals without being stigmatized as teachers' pet. We have basically enjoyed a high school career together, but this is the night that ends our high school career. Now, for the first time in our lives,
We're going to venture out from the proverbial protective wings of parents and guardians. It's going to be a difficult time to leave home for college, the military, or whatever choice we have decided upon. It's going to be a time of adjustment for us and also for our families. Many will undoubtedly become homesick, but that's okay. Just remember, the best thing you can do is believe in yourself. Don't be afraid to try. Don't be afraid to fail. Simply try again after calling or writing someone you miss dearly. I wish you all good luck in your future endeavors. Thank you.
That's the largest group of hearing impaired kids ever to graduate here. People tend to associate deaf with dumb. You haven't given us a chance to prove that we are the dumb because we can compete with everyone and come out successful in spite of our handoff. You haven't been a good experience for us because we were forced to be independent. We learned to live in a hearing world where we were not surrounded by deaf people. As a result, we have grown up being comfortable with hearing people and independent because we can blend into a hearing world. Many high school age deaf kids attend the state school for the deaf. You have a better choice for us because we learned to get along with our peers. If we had gone to the state school for the deaf, we would not have the opportunity to succeed in the same world that you live in. In the past, deaf students were restricted to specialized classrooms. Today, we are in mainstream classes and it has helped us academically. We have better skills because mainstream classes require more intensive preparation. In fact, you have special opportunities have given us a chance to do things and to learn things we would not have any place else. Not everything has worked out perfectly well for us, though. Our disability has caused us to run into some problems, some funny and some not so funny. For one thing, imagine going to school with the same 10 kids for 13 years. It's like being in class with your brothers and sisters all day long. There's no way of keeping anything a secret, and no one ever lets you forget a mistake you've made. It was also hard sometimes to get people to understand situations that are special problems for us, stuff that most kids don't even think about. For example, some kids think we have a big advantage in class because we have interpreters and notators with us. They're sure that our interpreters are helping us cheat on spelling tests in English classes. They don't realize how hard you have to concentrate to understand the interpreter or to speak with the teacher. Besides that, the teacher has a built-in washcloth because the interpreter usually knocks on you if you're not paying attention in class. Hearing kids can fall asleep in class and no one ever knows it, but not us. Also, most people think that since we're deaf, noise can't possibly bother us. Wrong. Little noises that hearing people can ignore, like pencil tapping or wind blowing in your ear, can just drive you crazy because our hearing aids amplify everything, not just voices. Really, growing up deaf is similar in most ways to being a normal teenager. We fight with our parents about curfew and complain about homework like everyone else. But we have to have more willpower to succeed in what we want to do. And sometimes, no matter how hard we work, we just end up following the herd until we figure out what's going on. Sometimes we feel like people hold us back because of our hearing loss. They don't always bother to find out what we can really do once communication problems are out of the way. Just have to learn from you guys. I think you hide a better place because we are here. You hide people have learned from us too. We notice that when we give reports in class, the other kids really pay attention. I guess it's because they want to know what we'll sound like. Since they don't hear us talk much, we often need sign language among ourselves. Kids don't know what to expect. Some of the teachers have learned a lot from us too. Mrs. Rob, Mrs. Blum, Mrs. Clausen, Ms. Delaney, Mr. Young, and Mr. Ganneray have done a really super job of treating us like they do everyone else. I guess having so many of us at one time forced us to sink or swim in their class. When we really started to succeed, I think our teachers became more comfortable about letting us go. That new independence will help the incoming kids next year at UHI. In closing, I think it's fair to say we've had some hard times, but we've had some good times too. We would never trade our 4 years at UHI for an easier, more protected adolescence. Best of all, we have pride in ourselves. Thank you very much and good night.
University High School. I do affirm that all the students on this stage have earned their degree. I ask that you prepare for the distribution of diplomas. Stephen Michael Adelman. Stephen J. Barbas. Kevin Michael Benz. Cynthia Dawn Beer. Andrew John Boaz. Carrie Marie Brooks. Diana Lynn Brown. Jennifer Ann Fromleving. Denise C. Burnett. Sarah Leslie Bushnell. Ike Andy Chu. Deborah Lee Kaufman. Jeffrey Dean Cole. Margo A. Cora. Monica Lee Corey. Karen A. Cullors. Jingo Dow. Michelle Marie Davis. Michael W. Detmers. Gulzar H. Donati. Susan Michelle Eichstadt. Anne Elizabeth Fairbairn. Robert Fan. Monique Elizabeth Finnegan. Deborah Sue Folks. Michael A. Fox. Walter Lee Fox. John W. Gordon. Deborah Suzanne Gould. Carol Gresham. Jane Marie Hinshaw. Carla May Hoffman. Stabile Jocelyn Poe. Judy Ray Hubbs. Gregory Dean Jackson. Thomas Alfred Jacob. Eric S. Johnson II. Angela Alice May Jones. Michael C. Jarenis. Stephanie Ann Gerbos. Sarah Louise Kaiser. Jeffrey Brian Carnes. Angela Marie Kapp. William A. Cow. Robert B. Kendrick III. Julie Ann Kerner. Todd C. King. Samuel Clemens Connect. Daniel Connell Kraft. Patricia Ann Craig. Ted A. Leisha. Scott C. Livingston. Claire Finn LaBelle. Kailas Nagaraj. Sybil Louisa Renette Ash. Lisa Marie Nelson. Holly Elizabeth Patterson. Lemon Earl Piggies. Dennis James Pearson. Douglas Mark Ramsey. Emily Joanne Raycraft. James Lloyd Robinson. Wojcik.
Karen Lynn Walter. Patrick T. Morley Jr. Laura B. Kinnett. Valerie Colan George. Teresa Carol Semo. Patricia Louise Ryan. D. Todd Moore. John David Zimmerman. Eunice Hobb. Daniel Jared Long. Stephen Sherrard. Susan Elizabeth Ross. Janessa Louise Williams. Rose Chang. David Lee Finkenmeyer. Sherry Louise Bradley. Lorraine Beth Cade.
takes a little bit. I'm on the side of you, so don't get hurt. Yeah, we'll have to handle it.
Kill it.
Hi, Grandpa. How are you?
Take a picture. Can I take a picture?
Don't get me.
Smile. Aren't you proud?
You guys are the best. Congratulations.